that things of the past were things of the past. And this coming so soon after we all pledged ourselves to peace and cohesion is a very sad day for me. And in that context, when we had the conversation, I'm like, I said it at Bintumanithi, I support peace, I support cohesion, and everybody has said there cannot be development without peace. And for me, the two have to go hand in hand. So it's a very sad day for me to hear all that transpired. And as Kanda is saying, this is our Sierra Leone. There's nowhere to go. Every door is closed. We have to make the best of here, we have to make the best of now. And in the spirit of a new direction, in the spirit of Bintumani 3, we felt we could not stay home. We could not just sit at home and say what they did was, what happened was wrong. We feel we have to know a little more detail. How did we get to this point so soon after we were all supposedly preaching peace? So for me, as I said, it's a very sad day. I do sympathize with all the suffering that you went through, and I'm also extremely concerned for those who have been incarcerated. What was their charge? What is the way forward? And how are we all going to really we're going to have to work together. We cannot present one face to the international community and present a different one to the people of Sierra Leone. It is very key. I hope you guys will be amenable to maybe us as shall we say, newbies, as it were, coming into this picture and finding common ground. We have to find common ground. This cannot be the way we're going to do things moving forward. Bintumanithi has to mean something. When I moderated, I said very clearly, we cannot leave Bintumanithi the way we came in. I didn't expect that we're going to be worse than when we came in. This for me is a very sad day. I really am. And those days are days that things that happened 30 years ago. Moving forward now, we all know we have to die. We simply have to die. It's very easy for somebody to have lost their life yesterday. Very easy. And this would be a whole different conversation. Mm-hmm. So we really all have to learn from the lessons and see how best we can move forward. It is essential. If we're claiming we really love the people of Sierra Leone, we have an obligation to do what we're doing. And that's the reason why I'm saying that. To every side, there's three sides to a story. The right side, the wrong side, and the truth. And you cannot stay at home and establish what the truth is or what are lies. So we have taken the onus to come and pay you a visit so we can establish where we're going wrong and what can we do as people who really care.
I think that SG is going to look around a little and going to organize to see how some can also, if IG is available, just visit and listen. Okay. And then we'll plan the next steps to approach governments as well.
Let me start on behalf of the party, the leadership of the party, to express our sincere gratitude to the two political parties, the NDC and the Unity Party. We are grateful to you for this show of concern. I want to assure you that we are not averse to the dialogue with the government. We are not averse to dialogue with the SNPP. In fact, at the center of dialogue when we were in power between the APC and SNPP, my humble self and Prince Harry. Every 2 weeks we meet to find out where problems are. People are arrested, like in Bo. Make sure we go there. So this is what we expected when the president, a week or so after the swearing-in ceremony, we reported the state of violence that had pervaded the whole country. We mentioned problems in the southeast. We mentioned keen not to drop engagement politics. We gave the name of the officer, never been arrested. So these are some of the problems. But we said, we have to see you, sir. Because I have to go to the protocol then. He said, you have to talk to Francis. I said, you talk to him, I don't know. We want to see, he is our own president. He's been declared president. So we must see him. Eventually, we were invited to go. And we took along the presidential candidate, Samora. It was there that Samora said, he's the president, congratulations. The intention was that he would feel confident. And then, going forward, take the high ground as president of Sierra Leone, as president of APC, SNPP, and other political parties. So when I catalogued the events that had occurred between the end of the election and the period we were meeting, he called on Prince Harry from Otto and gave a catalogue of what had happened before and during the election. I said, Mr. President, these things we are complaining about are ongoing. We want us to collectively put a stop to them. That is why we are here. We are not here to relate past events. We are worried about ongoing violence. We go to play ground and said, okay, forget about that. In that case, I will appoint you, Yansane, and Prince Harry to head cross-party committee. And that committee was never settled. 3 weeks after, I tried to get the president through the protocol, I was not able. I tried to get Prince Harry. He said, well, I want to put me forward, put us, wait for us. I said, Prince, this is not fair. Please, let us start. So I went to the ONS. I said, you were supposed to be part of this committee, the NGC, I suggested to the president, and the C4C. We also wanted the human rights representation and the police and the army. So this constituted the cross-party committee. We went all over the country. The report was presented by the former ONS boss. We asked him, he said, oh, I don't get the power. Asked the new man, oh, I don't know anything about that. So we tried. Prince Harry, what has happened to the report? We want the president to see this. He told us that anybody found perpetrating violence would be dealt with. He said, President, maybe you could even tell them that you will reprimand them. So let us start on the first place. This is what we wanted. Your representatives were there. So what we are saying is that we welcome the initiating one as state justice. It is our hope only that it will not be interpreted. They want in a political party, and that's the same thing. Because, to be honest, we thought if the Ministry of Political Public Affairs of Syria, they should have been in a position to say, let us call a meeting of all the political parties. But one man who said he has incorporated the APA, All Political Parties Association, as a corporate entity, a company, one Dr. Sandy, who was praised at the conference. It was he who took the initiative for a national dialogue. He came here, I said, this is the first time I'm meeting you, and I have to call you. Let us meet as APA. APA is divided. SLPP had withdrawn. If you go and prepare a constitution without the signature of APC, SLPP, and the two political parties, other political parties in parliament, it will be difficult. Let us wash our own limits as political parties and the PPRC. Thereafter, we can engage. There. It is important, but we all must be part of the preparatory process so that at the end of the day, we take ownership of the product of such event. Now, it didn't happen that. And as I sit here, nobody from Ministry of Political and Public Affairs ever called me. It was my brother, the minister. We met at the village. I want this national dialogue. That was 6-7 months ago. I said, this is very good. I said, but go through PPRC. It is better that way. You are an appointee of the president. We may not be in a position to be neutral. Let us get a neutral organization to spearhead this. You can be upset. So this is the situation. So I have a copy of our position on the Binkumani. It is not that we boycotted you. We were not invited. And I can assure you that you were also not invited until the day before. Then, this is our first statement. The part that they said is inciting is the party shall communicate in due course through the appropriate channel any further action it may wish to take. I don't know what is inciting about it. We have said that we're declaring the 2 days as strength day. This is in protest. We have a right to protest and we have grievances. And these grievances are set aside. See, so this is our first statement. If you go to the Facebook, you will see Mr. Bahai Lawrence Freeman's statement threatening us for making this statement. So when the IG invited me, I said, it's good for you to invite me. I wish the Minister of Interior were here and his deputy. It would have helped. Let us talk to each other. They've never spoken to us. They are in charge of internal security. They've never spoken to us. What we have from them is threats. Arrest, we will arrest you. So we are prepared. Assure the President that we are for peace in this country, but we also are not going to be compliant to unconstitutional behavior. We want to be guided by our constitution. We want to be guided by our constitution.
Well, on behalf of Unity Party and the NGC, sister Femi and myself, we thank you for making time. We've listened to you and we've organized now to see how we approach it. Would you mention the Minister of Interior? Because we have sent a text to the IG, but we'll do the same with the Minister of Interior. And we'll organize ourselves to see how over the next few days we'll talk to everybody, see how we can create an opportunity for a discussion. Yeah? And all we'll ask is keep the temperature down. Let us lower the tensions, let's not escalate. We hope all sides will not escalate. Those we cannot meet now will call by phones as well to see when we can get an appointment. But we're just asking for de-escalation so that others can come in, other senior citizens can also get involved to see how we can create a more regular mechanism for dialogue. Thank you very much. We wish you well. And we hope also those that are incarcerated, they can take a decision again to sort that out.
That is also very important because they are at the CID. I'm going there now and I hope they will see reason to release those who are sick, those who are wounded, and to assure us that they'll be provided for.
Yes.
Because yesterday they were not given food. Those that we never got any food. So we are sending food there.
It is good you mentioned. So Honorable Sidi Tounis was able to come to the CID and got Mohammed and
Mohammed. He went there because of Mohammed.
Okay.
As a member
of parliament, yeah. Okay. All right, well, we will see what else we will do now in the next few hours. We're always on the
move. This escalating tension should go particularly to the Ministry of Interior. Because rumors are making the rounds that Lima is heading a team of military and police personnel to go and arrest President Obama in the jail.
Really?
Yeah.
So these are the...
I'm just going from a former first lady's residence. Mm-hmm. She confirmed that to me.
Oh.
In fact, I came to relate to the Secretary General.
Yeah. I called the police. We don't know about that. She said, what happened? No.
Yes.
He's the boss of your ministry.
Let him try and see.
I am very concerned about the proportion, the number of women.
Yes.
There are scenes of women that are almost stripped naked.
Yes.
Those are scenes that we should not be seeing in these days.
Yes.
So I'm very shocked about that, and you know, I will, as we proceed to speak with the IG, appeal that whatever should be done speedily, and such scenes are no longer appropriate and not will be tolerated. It is a very sad day for us. There are so many women that are there, and how can they be held without food? Something needs to be done.
So we sent food yesterday. A junior officer said, "You man, until I bring trouble for them, we yourself will not arrest you." Why they arrest me? That food I bring for them, and we will ask for permission for bringing food.
Can I keep this?
Yes, that's it.
Of course, we'll bring you live pictures here from the headquarters of the All People's Congress Party, where we had a confrontation yesterday between the Sierra Leone police and members of the All People's Congress Party. And of course, we've listened to the secretary. Yes, to catch him. National Grand Coalition, Kande Kola Yumkela, and of course, we also had the Unity Party.
Give way.
The listening part that they observe at going out. I mean, like to talk to highlighted one thing. Kande Kola Yumkela here, making rounds and observing all what happened here. We can show you canisters of Tiaga that went here yesterday, and of course start bottles around the hall of the All People's Congress Party. But very shortly we have time to talk to the flag bearer of the Unity Party in the just election in 2018. That's Femi Kosko, and we hope to an explanation about what happened because as she said, this is a listening party, and as the senior citizens who moderated sessions of the just concluded Bintumani 3, this is a time because this is what they discussed before having this incident here yesterday, and is a concern for them, not only as head of political parties, but also as senior citizens of the Republic. And of course, I'm here with Tokande, whilst you were working with Attorney General. You came up with something that immediately after Bintumani 3, less than a week after Bintumani 3, and this happened. It's a concern going forward on all that was discussed at Bintumani 3.
Well, Madam Femi Claudio School and I are here because, in fact, we believe in Bintumani 3. That's our first reason why we decided to come, because we went there, genuinely participated, and if we see anything that will, any event action that will undermine what we believe we have accomplished in Bintumani 3, we will not sit back. We'll try to intervene to lower the tension in the country and de-escalate it. Second, we are leaders of political parties. It is our responsibility. Party is called Unity Party. Mine is a grand coalition of progressives. We live here. We want peace and stability. So we're here. We came to see Mr. Yansane and the APC to assess for ourselves. We also plan now to call the Minister of Interior, the IG Police, to listen to that side of the story as well. But we're very concerned. We're very concerned. And we want to be part of a dialogue that will in fact ensure that these things don't happen. Whatever caused it, let us see if we can be a part of the solution.
So as you listen to both parties, that is the Sierra Leone Police and of course supporters of the All People's Congress Party, what will be your message to both parties going forward?
We are asking both sides to de-escalate. Yeah? We don't want any additional action in the next few hours, next few days that will destabilize the country. So we are asking all sides to pull back, and let them allow dialogue. So we, as part of Bintumani 3, we will engage with the government as well, the international community that helped to put Bintumani 3 together. But we wanted to have facts first. So by coming here to see for ourselves, we'll also visit the police, we'll visit with government, our parties will back us now to put the right teams together to do further information collection. We are concerned. We live here. I mean, she lives right down the road. So this is genuine. Yeah.
And of course, that was Dr.